And don't say we don't, because that's exactly what we want. And the same is true with parenting. We can do this all day. We can put this on every area of life. I was having a conversation recently about how people are no longer raising their children. They're just babysitting them until they turn 18. And in reality, isn't that really what we're doing? And interestingly enough, the more we talk about parenting, there's parenting magazines, there's parenting TV channels, there's parenting events, you know, bring your kids to see the Wiggles at the local arena. Oh, this is parenting. Yay. The more we talk about parenting, the more it becomes an issue. Even the president has gotten involved in the discussion. The less we actually talk about raising children. Now, if you were to have a dog, and I don't have kids, so I understand that this might be a crude analogy, and I'm not telling you that your child is a dog. But if you were to have a dog, and you just let the dog run around in the yard and tossed food at it, would the dog survive? Yes. Would it be the dog of your dreams? No. Because you're not raising the dog. The dog isn't becoming the dog that you want it to be. And isn't it interesting how we've convinced ourselves that, well, Josh, I can't raise children. We have to allow them to be all that they want to be, and they have to decide what they want to be. And yes, there is some self-determination on the child's part there, absolutely. But that doesn't negate the fact that you're supposed to raise them. And what does it mean to raise them as opposed to just babysit them until they turn 18? Well, we know what babysitting them looks like. Look around your neighborhood, and that's what it looks like. Parents that say, oh, well, I can't really discipline my child because somebody in a building someplace told me that that wasn't right. Well, I can't really teach them about our culture because that's not right. That's insensitive, so I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to give them entertainment. I'm going to provide them with iPads, phones, and televisions. I'm going to give them food. And when they have a hissy, I'll just give them whatever they want. And then I'll remind myself that this is parenting and it takes a village. And when they turn 18, then it'll be all happy days again. Now, you're smart enough to know that things work generationally. What happens 2 generations from now? What's happening in this generation? Is it a result of what we've given up in a previous? To raise a child means you take care in understanding what they know, how they know it, how they think, how their belief system is formed. It is up to you to develop that. It's not up to the individual child to develop it all by itself. That's why people grow up with no belief system, and I'm not even talking about religion. Calm down. But they have no belief system, no structure to life. They're all lost, which is why divorce is crazy, suicide's crazy, drug use is crazy, unhappiness is crazy. Because we're not raising children. All right, we'll be back right after this.